Hi guys, I'm Nancy, and I'm going to show you how to remember the unit circle in trigonometry. What is the unit circle? Well, it just means a circle with a radius of 1, that's all. It sounds simple. Actually, there are a lot of angle values and sine and cosine coordinates that you end up having to memorize. So knowing the unit circle is kind of a necessary evil. But don't worry, I'm going to show you some patterns and tricks that will help you remember it. Okay, so let's take a look at this. This is our unit circle. These are our axes. This is the x-axis, and this is our y-axis. These two lines touch the circle at 4 points: the right, the top, the left, and the bottom. When you're finding an angle on the unit circle, we always start here on the right side, and we move up counterclockwise. We rotate to get to angles all the way around. So let's look at the four angles you get at this point, and this point. So this first angle is 0 because that's where we're starting. Then if we move up and rotate counterclockwise through a quarter of the circle, we have the angle pi over 2. These angles are in radians, not degrees. They have pi in them. Then if we move another quarter of the way through the circle, we have the angle pi. This is half the circle. So the whole circle will be 2 times that, 2 pi. Then if we move another quarter of the way through the circle, we have the angle 3 pi over 2. 1 quarter through the circle was pi over 2. So 3 quarters of the way around the circle is 3 pi over 2. Okay, finally, if we move another quarter circle, we get 2 pi. Now we've come full circle. And notice this angle here, this position, is 0, but also 2 pi. Okay. Now let's look at the pi over 4 angles. Those other angles we just did divided the circle into 4 equal parts. These are going to divide it again. So if 1 quarter was pi over 2, if we divide it again by 2, we get pi over 4. And these ones are always in the exact center of the quarter circle. The first one is 1 pi over 4, just pi over 4. Next one is 3 pi over 4. Then 5 pi over 4, then 7 pi over 4. Notice that pattern, 1, 3, 5, 7. So as you can see, this is rapidly turning into a disaster. Now we have the pi over 6s. So if 1 quarter of the circle is pi over 2, a third of that, if you divide by 3, is pi over 6. So the first over 6 is pi over 6. Then if we mirror it on the other side of the axis, we have 5 pi over 6. Down here, 7 pi over 6. And down here, 11 pi over 6. Okay, finally, we have the pi over 3s. The first pi over 3 is here. It might seem wrong to you that pi over 3 is bigger than pi over 6, but remember you're dividing by those numbers. You're dividing by 3 here, but you're dividing by a bigger number, 6 here, so this is actually a smaller, lower value than that. Anyway, this is pi over 3. If you reflect it across the y, you have 2 pi over 3. Down here is 4 pi over 3, and down here is 5 pi over 3. All right. Now let me show you what the unit circle is actually good for, and that is knowing the cosine, sine, and tangent values of each of these angles. Each of these angles that we drew in touches the circle at a point. So let me show you some of these points. All right, so every angle on the circle touches the circle at a point, an x, y point. It has an x coordinate and a y coordinate. So for this angle, 0, the x coordinate is 1 because this is a unit circle. It has a radius of 1. So the x distance is 1. And the y coordinate is 0 because this point has no height. The distance in the y direction is 0. Now, this is very important. These two coordinate values also give you your cosine and sine. The first value, the x coordinate, is always your cosine. And the second value, the y coordinate, is always your sine. So, for this angle of 0, the cosine is 1 and the sine is 0. Now let's move to the top of the circle at pi over 2. The x distance is 0 and the y distance is a full 1 unit. So we have 0 comma 1, the cosine is 0, the sine is 1. On the left side we have negative 1, 0, x, y coordinates. On the bottom of the circle we have 0, negative 1. All right, so let's fill in the points for the other angles in the circle. All you need to remember are these three numbers. You probably wish they were nice, neat, whole numbers, but they're not. They have square roots and fractions in them. Just remember, 1/2 is the smallest number. Square root of 2 over 2, or root 2 over 2, is the middle-sized number. And root 3 over 2 is the largest number. You're going to be using these again and again and again. So let's look at the angle pi over 6. For the angle pi over 6, that point has an x distance that is the largest of these three angles. So its x coordinate needs to be root 3 over 2. So we write that there. For pi over 4, for that angle, the x distance is a little smaller, so it's the middle-sized number, root 2 over 2. Then, for the angle pi over 3, the x distance is the smallest of the three, so it has to be 1/2 for the x coordinate. All right. Now let's fill in the y values for those points. It's the exact same idea. For the angle pi over 6, the y distance, the height, is the lowest of those angles, so it needs to be 1/2, the smallest value. At pi over 4, the height, the y distance, is the middle size, so it needs to be root 2 over 2. And then at pi over 3, the y distance, the height, is the largest of the angles, so it needs to be root 3 over 2. All right, now you can figure out all the other points for the other angles in the circle. It's the exact same idea. The only thing that's different is that you might have a negative sign. The only thing you need to watch out for is maybe having a negative sign for your coordinates, like here. When you were in the first quadrant, the first quarter of the circle, everything was positive. All of these coordinates were positive numbers. But if you're in the second quadrant, the second quarter, you've actually moved in the negative x direction, left. So all of the x numbers will be negative, have a negative sign. But the y's are still positive because you're in the positive half of the y-axis. Then in the third quadrant, the third quarter, you're in the negative x direction and the negative y direction because you've moved left and down. So both the x's and the y's will have negative signs here. In the fourth quadrant, the fourth quarter, you're in the positive x direction because you moved right, and you're in the negative y direction because you moved down. So positive x coordinate, negative y coordinate. So I just want to remind you, for all of these points, for all of these angles, the first number in the point is the cosine value, and the second number is the sine. So here, for 3 pi over 4, the cosine is negative root 2 over 2. And the sine of 3 pi over 4 is root 2 over 2. So if you have to figure out the cosine of pi over 3, it's the first value in the point. The answer is 1/2. If someone asks you, what's the sine of 7 pi over 6? Go to your unit circle. Sine is the second value in the point. So the sine of 7 pi over 6 is just negative 1/2. That is the answer. All right, just a few reminders for you. This whole time we were working in radian angles, all these angles, pi over 6. Those are all radian angles. You may need to work in degrees, and all of them have a corresponding degree angle. You might already know that pi is 180 degrees, so that would mean half of that, pi over 2, is 90 degrees. This, of course, is 0 degrees, and that would make pi over 6 30 degrees, pi over 4 45 degrees, pi over 3 60 degrees, 90 degrees, and so on. Also, if you're trying to memorize the unit circle, I know it's a lot to take in. It's kind of a mess. But just remember the patterns, because those patterns are what will make it a lot faster to learn and a lot easier to learn. So I hope that helped you figure out the unit circle. Unit circles are lots of fun. It's okay. You don't have to like math, but you can like my video. So if you did, please click like or subscribe.